Alafia, aho, I say namaste, and thank you for watching Shadow of Wolves, and blessings to all of you, and blessing to you, you, and you with blessing. Let's talk about Holy Week, all of your questions regarding Holy Week, your questions about revocation and prayers and what to do during Holy Week. This video is made for those of you who follow Lukumi faith, for those of you who need protection, those of you who have faith in your spiritual practice, in your spiritual work. I am mainly focused on the energy of Santeria and Lukumi. Why? Because during this week, there is a lot of messages going around regarding, there are a lot of messages going around regarding what do we do? How do we pray? What do we do with our Orisha? Or what do we do with ourselves, our warriors, and so forth? Now, let's begin in blessings to all of you. This week being Holy Week, this upcoming Friday, in blessings to Christ, in blessings to Yeshua, in blessings to the spiritual energy of Him dying for our sins and crucifixion and so forth. Those of you who don't believe, well, goodbye, change the channel, keep it moving. I'm focusing on those who are believers and who respect their faith. Now, here is a Selenite wand. Remember, I always spoke to you guys about Selenite. I spoke to you about the energy of prayer and what we need to do to follow through with the energy of prayer and how we need to combat that energy and working with cleansing ourselves and working with the power of the knife, okay? If you cannot find this, and blessings to an elder that sent this to me, Ma Ferefunia Mayat, you can also use a regular Selenite wand. It replenishes you. Now, in talking about Good Friday, here are some of the do's and don'ts based on Lukumi, based on Santeria, based on how I was raised from my mother in being born Catholic, okay? For that whole week, the whole week, there are no meats, there are only fish and vegetables and a lot of fasting. But as I have gotten older, in respect to Good Friday, in respect to Holy Week, we really start getting more strict about what we're eating on Good Friday, okay? And I will explain why. We, as a faith, have Orisha. Let's talk about that. I've heard some people saying that they are covering their Orisha, they are covering their spiritual tools. Some are emptying waters from their spiritual table because either they don't know or they don't have guidance. So to cover your Orisha, even if you are in a Leo and you have your warriors or you have a Lokun or you have your Ibejis and so forth, do know that this is not the time to cover Orisha. Two energies are completely different, but of course in our faith, we are built on our spiritual practice of prayers because why? Our ancestors have traveled during the slave trade or wherever around the world. We were Christianized as well, so we give a lot of respect to the Bible. We give a lot of respect to prayers. Now, many people feel like they don't know what to do around Holy Week. Let's talk about some defensive work, okay? The angel, the archangel, and this is also in scriptures, that will continue fighting relentlessly and keep defending you is Archangel Michael, continuously. So during the time of crucifixion, it has already happened, and with all blessings, Yeshua has already died for our sins and suffered, right? So we remember the date and being respectful and understanding his resurrection and so forth. Like I said, we all have different faiths. If that is your belief, blessings to you. If it's not, blessings to you. So now, what do we do during this Holy Week? Do we cover Orisha? No, we don't. Please follow the guidelines of your Ile. Your Associate, follow those guidelines. We continue praying up until Good Friday. Why am I making this video? Because you are in spiritual battle. You're always in spiritual battle. If you're watching this video or you're watching like high spiritual people, you are in a spiritual battle. You just have to decide which warfare you're going to be involved in. Which warfare are you in? We are always in spiritual battle. The minute that you're walking late at night after 12 midnight and you're walking through your door, all sorts of energies are following you. You are in spiritual battle. If you are one of those people like myself who are always effortlessly and fighting to save people and cleanse people from your heart and to do readings and to tell the truth, and you evolved and your spiritual practice within your mind frame, within your chakras, inner and outer, has evolved, you're in spiritual battle. If you're staying low in the third dimension and you're not moving up to the fifth and so forth, and you at this moment know that there are many mansions and there are many realms that we need to abide by and that we need to go by a law of order, you're in spiritual battle. Those of you who pray, those of you who are nurses, doctors, caregivers, those of you who love children, take care of children, respect the elderly, you're in spiritual battle. Believe me, you are. And I know who you are. And I have a message for you. How do you deal with the different religions, meaning to rely on, that you indoctrinated yourself in or you got initiated in and so forth? How? Well, in order to respect that, who is going to fight for you? Archangel Michael. Doesn't matter what you see here, whether he's black, white, Asian, red. Listen, Archangel Michael, those of you who are going to respect and follow the protocol of what I'm about to show you, stay tuned. But Archangel Michael is the archangel that is going to defend you no matter what. Try to do this all the way up until Friday. If you can't do it Friday, after this weekend, after Sunday, you can do this at any given moment. But why are we using white in this case? Because it is Holy Week. Why are we using a white candle? Because it is Holy Week. So when you're doing a revocation at your door, some of you who are my godchildren are blessing, some of you who are Hugan, some of you are Mambos, you know Belier Bekan is synchronized with Archangel Michael. Upon this revocation, as you're doing this before Thursday, please make sure for him you must leave coins. You can leave 3, 7, or 9. Please remember that, of pennies, to this offering once you're doing the revocation at your door. Those of you who are Sansistas, the same. Those of you who are exploring and you need help and you're calling, Archangel Michael will be there. I'm going to give a testimony towards the end. He is there. However you imagine him, do know that Archangel Michael is a warrior. Not only does he defend our ethereal cord and our cord to get us back through nightmares and through dreams and through astral travel, which is a silver cord, he can bring you back. But also do know he has no problem in defeating any evil that's around you that you don't want. So let's begin. Normally, when we're doing a revocation, okay, we are using eggs. This was given, I was given permission to share my style with you. Okay, it cannot be used against me. It cannot be used against you, because no weapon against you, and I say against, shall prosper. You are the weapon. So follow this. Raw egg. Okay, you're going to have a raw egg. You're going to pray. And as you are praying, you pray the prayer that you're most comfortable with. In this case, once again, you're going to call on Archangel Michael. In this case, once again, if you're more comfortable, Belier Bekan. So as you're cleaning yourself, you're going to make sure that this egg touches every part. Please be careful with it. If it breaks, get another egg. You're going to cleanse all of your energy, your stomach especially, because you have 7 chakras. And those chakras from your root and up are the 7. Then you have them all over your hands and feet. Cleaning your main 7 chakras, you're still going to cleanse your arms and your aura and your energy. Not only is this a very beautiful revocation in return to center, but it also keeps any energy of whatever is attached to you at bay and away. Have faith in what you're doing. As you cleanse yourself, this is a demonstration, you're going to use salt water. Why are we not using vinegar during this time of Holy Week? Because vinegar was considered as a mockery to Christ when he was on the cross. So we're not using vinegar. We are using sea salt and water. You don't have to write anything in this glass. Archangel Michael, Belier, Bekan, and your guardian angels and your spirit guides, they work together. They already know what is going on. You may want to clean yourself, but if there's an injustice, some of you have dealt with slander, some of you have dealt with lies, jealousy, lack of truth, and there's an injustice towards everything that you have strived to achieve. Do a revocation at your door. If you're seeing this year or next year or whenever, it's fine. Holy Week needs to be respected, so this has sea salt. Your sea salt can consist of 3 to 7. This is salt. This is a demonstration once again. 3 to 7 to 9 teaspoons or tablespoons of salt. It's up to you. Okay, now, with the blessing of that, you're going to take this energy and you're going to put it in a glass. The glass. There you go. Boom. So now you have your revocation being prepared. As you are doing this, please make sure those of you who don't know, you cover your head. Once again, this is a demonstration for you. So as you are praying to Archangel Michael, defend us in battle. Okay, defend us from the snares of the devil. You say whatever prayer is coming to your mind. Archangel Michael, I am tired. Defend me. Work with me. Those of you who are Sansistas or Mambos, or Hogans, Archangel Belier Bekan, defend me. I'm asking for your assistance. He will come. But you must pray to who? You must pray to God first, okay? Those of you who say Papa Bon Dieu, those of you who say God, and so forth. So can you do this revocation at your door during Holy Week? Yes, you can. Now, you have until a certain time, Good Friday, is a day that we give a lot of respect. Now, you see how I have this on the glass? Many of the people who I have read in card readings, you already know what to do, but I'm showing this for those who need to know. Your eggs are in here, your salted water is in here, your glass is here. Please, please, do not be worried about perfection. Your prayer and your energy of fighting any kind of anything that you've picked up or that was sent to you, focus on that. Focus on the light and the bright light of him taking this away. You're going to hold the glass. It's a reversal spell, a revocation, and you're going to flip it. There you go, baby. You're going to flip it, okay? Now, as you flip this, here is where more powerful energy for you comes in, because whatever you're working with, whatever prayer you're saying, it's going to be achieved, especially if you feel like this week, you know, you have to continue fighting evil, witchcraft, brujeria, or just simply you have bad energy on you. Now, you have until Friday, Good Friday. Once you see this video, and it's at any time during the year, you can do this, but I'll tell you the difference. Now, we are working with the energy of the color white in respect for Holy Week, okay? So normally, you're going to use this particular revocation for 3 days. You can leave it like this, and if you see the water seeping out, it's okay. Those of you who are fighting demons or spirits that don't agree with you or don't like you for whatever reason or whatever you got on you, do it for 9 days. So you have 3, 7, or 9. You must get chime candles. This is very important. His colors, I'm respecting Holy Week, so I'm going to show you. His colors are green for us and red, okay? Green and red for us. Then you will clear it up with a white candle. Repeat for the next 9 days if it's really bad. If all you need is 3 days, all you need is 3 days. Now, you're going to do what we said, a revocation. Here is my example for you. And I'm hoping that this is something those of you who are new can grasp. What we do here, I cut the top of the candle already. Remember, it's reversal. This part, you take it out. Okay? This is Holy Week, so I'm showing you with a white candle. You flip it, And then what you're going to do is you're going to dig it out with your sacred knife or knife that you have that you keep for your spiritual blessing. And you're going to turn the candle upside down. It's a revocation. Hello. And you're going to take the wick and you're going to pull it out. And then once you pull the wick out, you're going to keep praying and keep praying and keep praying. Archangel Michael, defend us in battle. Archangel Michael, defend us in battle. Keep praying. You can look on the phone and or print it out and be looking at it like this. Pray, 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 pray. Then once you do that, and I'm going to show you an example of what was done here. You're going to take the bottom of this, okay? Take your time. I'm only going to, now some of you, you know to use matches. Once again, this is a sample video. Once you get the candle to stick, you're going to light the top of it and you're going to keep praying and keep praying. Yes, this is a reversal. Let's continue on. Now, once again, this is an example. Let me continue with you, okay? Now, if you're watching this video after Holy Week is over, remember his colors. You're going to use green. Then you're going to use red. Remember, you're going to cut the top of this off. It's a reversal. And you're going to dig out the wick patiently and you're going to light it. You're going to do that. Now, your third day, don't forget to light the white candle, okay? It's a revocation. If on the third day you're feeling good and the energy is good, then you can light it facing towards the heavens and do your prayer, okay? So you're going to light it in that sync, okay? Now, make sure that everything is in synchronicity because it's for your blessing. This Holy Week, believe me, your enemies, I'm going to teach you something. They're going to be at work. It's very disrespectful, but they're going to be at work on Friday. For the mockery of Christ, they're going to be at work on you. They're going to be at work on you on Saturday too. Saturday is not only the day for Saturn, but everything lets loose. So you better wake up, say your prayers, do what you got to do. Now, for us, what we do to make it, to kick it up a notch, I like to take, and I'm going to show you, I'm going to remove this spoon. Once I've done this work here, this is once again an example, and then I'll show you the real work. Okay, this is what you're supposed to do, then I'll show you mine. You're going to take sea salt. And you're going to put this protective energy around your cleansing and your work. If you have children, everybody can have one of these, honey. Put it at your door. If you don't have space, find a way. Archangel Michael is walking with you. Okay, honey? Let's go. All right, now, what you're going to do is, for me, I continue on, and you can use an odd number of eggs again. So you're going to clean yourself. You can use 3 or 5. In this case, you're cleaning yourself. I'm going to use 3 to show you. 1, keep this protected. Clean yourself. Clean, example, clean, clean, clean. Even the bottom of your feet has chakras. 2, clean yourself again. Clean, 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 clean. 3, then you're going to take some cascaria, which we also call efum. If you can go online and look this up, you can look it up on Amazon or wherever you feel comfortable. Okay, you're going to take the cascaria and you're going to sprinkle it around. Sprinkle it around, and you could do this 3 times. Then counterclockwise, sprinkle it around. Your faith is the biggest energy of your life. As you're sprinkling this around, you're going to pray. If you're thinking one negative thing, you're going to shoot yourself down. 100%. Now, look at how beautiful this is. All I have to do is take, and remember, the candle is in reverse, and light this, and boom, it is done. So mote it be. Now, remember for Beliebekan, those of you who are Sansistas and who just had Sanse completed, those of you who are Mambos and Hugons, you have 21 division, and we're blessing for you initiated in voodoo, and blessings to you. Remember, Beliebekan is there. I don't know what he's calling voodoo, but for us, for 21 division, Beliebekan, for Sanse, Beliebekan. Now, once you take this, you're going to, this is what mine's look like. This has been lit. What you're going to do this, When it's all finished and completed, you're going to take it, put everything, take it outside. Okay, let the water fall back to earth, Mother Earth, if there's still some water left. You see, this was worked on. There's not that much water in this. What you're going to do is put this in a brown paper bag, okay, with 3 pennies. Take it to a crossroad. Take it to a crossroad. Crossroad looks like a cross, not near your house. Take that brown paper bag with the eggs, with 3 pennies in there, and throw it behind you. Let it break. Do not look over there anymore ever again. So mote it be. Archangel Michael is a very, very powerful energy. Doesn't matter how you perceive him or what color you perceive him. Why? Energies of archangels, of seraphim, cherubim, and all of the archangels are nothing but pure fire, baby. Some of them have millions of eyes. Not all of them have human-like qualities. So in respect to you, do know, I remember my testimony is that one day, many years ago, I had a dream someone was tying me up. This was way before I got crowned in Orisha faith. Way before I even knew what Sanse was. I was in my 20s, man. And I remember being tied up. So I said, oh, Jesus, help me, help me, help me. Well, with all respect, his real name, with all respect, I'm not here to cause controversy, is Yeshua. But I was calling on, Jesus, help me, help me. And I was still getting tied up. I said, please, Archangel Michael, save me. All I saw was a big pair of wings and I saw a mighty sword. But he didn't let me see his face and it was gone. So this is why I'm telling y'all to hold fast to your faith. People are going to say negative things at work. Maybe you're not battling witchcraft. Maybe you're just battling haters or enemies or whatever. Or you're battling yourself and you need to do prayers for yourself because something doesn't feel right with your energy. Do this and follow up for the next upcoming videos in spiritual protection. I pray for all of you. Remember, those of you who are watching, please like, share, subscribe, and so forth. Hit that notification bell. I pray that you always have peace, power, and plenty. Many are called, few are chosen. I'm rushing to do this video, and I didn't plan it, but only for today, because this is my own personal work. But I'll tell you something. I was asked to send this out to those that it will reach. Why? Why is that? The reason why I am planning to do this, and I was asked to do this, is because there is a spiritual battle. Please, those of you who are in our faith, look up the letter of the year. Whatever you do, and however you feel, and whatever you're going through, is a blueprint and a restart for this year. You have a lot of blessings. Stay in a higher elevation. Many are called and few are chosen. You don't need me. You don't need a group. You don't need to be part of this church or that Elay. You don't want to. Stay within the realm of God and the realm of yourself. And do know that there are higher level beings and higher angels and so forth that are fighting for you. Do know that you're never alone. It doesn't matter who you or what you believe in. Believe in yourself. That's what you need to do first. So in blessings, I hope that those of you who understood the revocation for Holy Week, we do not take out our waters. We do not cover our orishas. We do not disrespect them. But Friday and Saturday, stay in prayer and be very, very careful. Why do we still pray on Friday and Saturday as Yeshua was the Son of God for us? You have your own opinions. So God is at a high level where we always need to be in prayer of God. Who was praying to God during the time of Passover and the Last Supper? Yeshua. Some of you say Jesus. Some of you say Christ. Yeshua prayed to his Father. He prayed to God and said, let this cup pass me. He felt that it was so strong what he had to do for this world. So why would you stop praying on a Good Friday or Saturday? Why? Okay, spiritual work. That's it. But why would you stop praying? Keep praying. Keep praying. and also to recognize the energy and peace of positive aspects of the higher self. Alafia, aho, I say namaste, and thank you for watching Shadow of Wolves, and blessings to all of you.